Seem to be struggling a little in the following turns. Turn 3, turn 5, turn 16, turn 17. This is the final lap of the program.
Thank you.
8 program complete. These results will do, although you could definitely do better. Consider giving it a... So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 25.0. Was a heck of an impact. Let me know you're okay. To pick up the pace, we're not hitting our target. We'll need to rerun the program if we don't get the time delta back in the green. We managed the pace well that lap, and tyre wear is more or less as expected. And a job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so... Testing fuel management here, so try to lift and coast going into the corners. Don't be too aggressive on the power, but remember, you still have to beat the minimum lap time. take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. The time last lap was a 1:23.6. This lap, please. Box this lap. When driving with the pit assist disabled, you'll need to be mindful of your speed when entering the pit lane. If you hit the limiter line too fast, you'll pick up a penalty. Watch the on-screen prompts that show your target speed and distance to the limiter line. You're nearly out of fuel, almost out of fuel. You need to pit within the next two laps. Car repairs have set us back a little. Our best lap so far is a 1 minute 20.3. If you want to know specific information or make certain changes to the car during a pit stop, you can tell me what you want over the radio. This is the ERS management test. Hit the target time whilst managing your battery charge. The more efficiently you use energy throughout the lap, the higher you will score. Use your overtake button for maximum power, but remember, that will drain energy rapidly. Program complete and a job well done.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three, who are
the owner driver,
Bottas,
and Charles Leclerc.
What an incredible practice session. The fun doesn't stop here, though. Join us again as the
Good day today. Let's have your take on it. You spent a lot of time on the track during practice. Does the car have enough reliability to sustain that? Do you think this team are performing as well as they could do? You left some bodywork out there on the track. Were you struggling for grip? Great. Well, that's everything.
this is a quali sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat.
The qualifying pace program, available in free practice sessions, challenges you to beat a target time that corresponds to...
Okay, Tesco. Program complete and a job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can talk you through the numbers. We've had to spend time repairing the damage to the car. Our best lap so far is a 1:19.3. Second in the speed trap, 170.2 miles per hour. Give us some consistent laps, please. We're looking for good data that we can work into the race strategy. Okay, super job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused. Was no good. We need you to improve. Lab, you've nailed what we asked for. Keep it up. Okay, super job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused. We'll be right back. Okay, test complete, and that was a very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that.
The session has drawn to a close, so let's review our top three. The owner... And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again.
Good day today. Let's have your take on it. You put in a lot of time on the track today. Was there a reason for this? Do you have any comments about this team? Great. Well, that's everything.
Thank you.
Okay, good job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Nelson Piquet once said that driving the Circuit de Monaco was like riding a bicycle around your living room. And it's not hard to see what he means by that. There's no more prestigious a Grand Prix victory than Monaco, but also none so challenging. The astonishing Circuit de Monaco is, for all intents and purposes, virtually unchanged since its inaugural race back in 1929. The faster cars of today, though, ensure the 19 corners past the casino and along the seafront remain as thrilling as ever. A 2.1-mile lap here takes us around an entire country, yet never more than inches from the race-ending barriers. Joining me for the Grand Prix once again is Anthony Davidson. Can we talk about Mercedes? What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. It's the owner driver in pole position then, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Leclerc, Sebastian Vettel, and Perez, Norris, Albon, Sainz, and Daniel Ricciardo, Stroll, Grosjean, Lewis Hamilton, and Kvyat, Gasly, Ocon, Kevin Magnussen, and Nobuharu Matsushita, Raikkonen, Russell, Giovinazzi, and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
Thank you.
nice start. Let's keep it up. Great work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. The car behind has started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. We're going to box this lap, push hard on the in-lap. We're leading our teammate by 24.4 seconds. We think you're going to start losing some tyre grip around now. At the moment, the car behind us is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. Nobuharu in the pits. Exit now. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. We'll be right back. to teammate behind is 32.6 seconds. Is gaining on you by 5/10 a lap.
Thank you.
have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Behind us is 3.2 seconds. We're leading our teammate by 44.1 seconds. Of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Nice work, that's P1. Race win, well done.
That's it then for another nail-biting Monaco Grand Prix. We were on the edge of our seats the whole time, but they've come through to take a stunning victory. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One. Let's see how the driver standings have changed. Our current championship leader dominated the track, securing a win and further increasing their advantage. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Carlos Sainz would be my first choice for this race. He had excellent race stamina, giving him the opportunity to charge through the ranks.
Thank you.
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed the quality control. Make sure you indicate what you'd like redeveloped via the R&D screen.